Okay, so today we are going to look at interrupts of 8085 microprocessor. So there are several hardware interrupts, that is, these interrupts are going to have pins. There are going to be 5 pins, 5 external pins of the microprocessor. If you make these pins, you connect these pins to VCC, that is, if you give them signal 1, then these pins are going to be active and you are going to raise a hardware interrupt. What happens when an interrupt is raised? See, actually, each interrupt has a routine, interrupt service routine, which is going to be saved in a memory. It is like a program only. Whenever you raise an interrupt, that is, whenever you make any of these pins as 1, then the microprocessor is going to finish the currently going program, currently executing instruction. After the instruction is executed, it is going to suppose if you raise RST 7.5, this is going to take the program to a particular location. The microprocessor will start with the particular location of memory and the program stored at that location is going to be executed. Okay, so these are the 5 interrupts. This is this pin, INTA bar. This is interrupt acknowledgement. Interrupt acknowledgement. And these are the 5 hardware interrupts. Okay, other than these, there are several software interrupts also. Now what happens is, currently executing instruction, the instruction that is being currently executed is never left in between. Whenever you raise an interrupt, the currently executing instruction is never left in between. The microprocessor will complete, always complete the currently executing instruction first. And after that, it is going to service the interrupt. Servicing the interrupt means routing to the address which is pointed by, which is already known for these interrupts. Okay, that is known as servicing the interrupt. So, there is a term known as interrupt service routine, interrupt service routine, ISR. Okay, what is ISR? ISR is a set of instructions, set of instructions to be performed. To be performed to service the interrupt. It's a set of instructions to be performed to service the interrupt. Okay, they are going to be saved in some particular memory location, and whenever you raise an interrupt, the microprocessor will route the program, and these particular set of instructions that are saved are to be executed. That is known as ISR or interrupt service routine. Fine. So, what happens is, initially a call function is performed, a call instruction is executed. Okay, we've already seen about the call instruction. So, what happens is, maybe if we have not seen, we'll see in further classes. Call instruction, what happens is, suppose you give an instruction like this, call and some address. Whenever this instruction is given in a program, what happens is, after completing the previous instruction, this current address, suppose this is at 2001, this is 2002. So we are using a stack. What happens is, after completing this instruction at memory location 2001, whenever you reach at this memory location 2002 and find call program, this memory location is going to be pushed into stack, the next memory location, suppose next is 2005. So this is going to be pushed into the stack, and call instruction, call address, suppose this address is 5070. This is going to be put in the program counter, and this, after completion of the instructions at this memory location, we are going to pop this memory, this location from the stack, and again execute this. Okay, so what happens when you raise an interrupt? Internally, a call operation is performed. Call operation is performed. Whatever is the address of the ISR, that is already known. That address is called using this call instruction. Internal call is performed. And after the ISR is completed, the interrupt service routine, whatever the commands you have written, those are completed. We come back to our previous program. Whatever program was being executed, that will resume. Okay, then there are 2 types of interrupts, vectored and non-vectored. So what is the difference between vectored and non-vectored interrupt? Address for these interrupts, that is address of ISR for these interrupts, is already known. And in non-vectored interrupts, address is not known. Okay, the location where the ISR is stored is not known. Okay, so here they are having fixed address. Fixed address. Four of the interrupts that we are learning here are vectored: trap, RST 5.5, RST 6.5, and RST 7.5. okay, these are vectored interrupts. INTR is a non-vectored interrupt. Non-vectored interrupt means address is not fixed, address is variable, we do not know where the ISR is saved. Okay, so address for trap is 0024C. This is 0024, 0034, and 0030C. Okay, so these are the fixed addresses for these four interrupts. Although address for this interrupt is not fixed, so this is a non-vectored interrupt. That is, if you are pressing this, if you are giving this pin INTR as 1, then anywhere, any address, it can lead to anywhere ISR may be saved. Address for these interrupts are fixed. So these are two types of interrupt, vectored and non-vectored. Okay, then again, out of these five interrupts, address for these are fixed, address for this is not fixed. And also there is a priority. Okay, that means if simultaneously two or more interrupts are given, then which interrupt will be serviced first, that is already decided. So highest priority interrupt is trap. So basically, generally trap is given only when there's a problem with the supply, maybe, or with the clock, there's some problem like that, then you're giving this interrupt trap. This is the highest priority interrupt. Highest priority interrupt means if trap and suppose trap and RST 5.5 come simultaneously, both these interrupts are made one, trap will be serviced first. First priority will be given to trap. Then next is RST 7.5, then RST 6.5, then RST 5.5, and INTR is the least priority interrupt. INTR is going to be least priority interrupt. Okay, then we have one more pin, INTA bar, which is to acknowledge interrupt. Whenever you are giving an interrupt to 8085, just to acknowledge that it has received the interrupt, it is going to complete the ISR, it's going to give this INTA bar. This is an active low pin, that means if this pin becomes 0, that means that is just acknowledge the interrupt. You're going to connect some LED or something here, okay? It is going to give a signal so that you know that interrupt is being acknowledged. So now what happens is, now you can understand better maybe. Suppose this is my microprocessor and I give RST 6.5. RST 6.5 means if I make this high, okay, I'm giving this pin as 1. Internally, what happens in the microprocessor is call 0034 is executed. Internally, call 0034 is going to be executed. The currently running program is going to be pushed into the stack and the program counter will be overwritten with the memory location 0034. The microprocessor will reroute to the memory location 0034 and complete the program, which is there at 0034, also known as ISR, interrupt service routine. At end of every ISR, there is going to be an instruction known as return. What does return do? Return pops the contents of the stack and then the program counter will resume the currently executing program. Okay, so it is the duty of the programmer to place a return at end of every ISR so that after completion of the ISR, that is after servicing each of the interrupt, the programmer can return to the main program, the currently executing program.